Hi, welcome to horizonhobby.com. I'm Jim Booker. Today I've got a hold of a new mCX, the mCX2. I've got the blade product developer Mark Padilla with me today, and Mark's been working on the mCX2 for some time. There's a few differences, things that you're going to like about this helicopter compared to the original. I'm sure a lot of people have had the original or have one. It's going to be a time to get a new one because this one's a lot of fun. It's got a lot of new features. You know, Mark, tell us about this thing. You've spent a lot of work and a lot of time on this thing, I know, because realistically, this has just been the hottest thing in the market for some time. And now you got a new mCX2.
Cool. Sounds good, Jim. Here, let me go ahead and take it off out of your hand. Well, this is our new blade mCX2. It features the coaxial rotor head system, just like our current mCX. This particular helicopter, though, has the full body. It's a nice, new, sleek design. Features a blue LED. Functional navigational light set that's already pre-installed. As you can see here on the tail, check that out. It's you know, blinking slowly. You got a green LED flashing on the right side and a cool red LED flashing on the left.
Let me ask you, Mark. We've got the mCX, the mCX S300, and the mCX Tandem Rescue, which, by the way, was not available as a bind and flight. Now, is this one going to be available as a bind and flight?
Oh, yeah. Yes, Jim. This is going to be available in bind and flight completion, which for those of you that are not familiar with a bind and fly completion level, that actually comes with one single cell battery now, four AA batteries for your charger, the charger, and the helicopter itself. So it's ready to bind to any, you know, compatible DSM-2 aircraft technology radios.
So. Okay, but the ready to fly also comes with the transmitter, so you've got everything you need to fly this thing right out of the box. Is there any assembly needed?
No, there's no assembly needed at all. I mean, if you buy the ready to fly, it's truly a one-box purchase. I mean, it's really cool. You know, if you purchase one for your relative, family member, all you need to do is just bring them the box and they're ready to fly.
Well, now, I really like those flashing navigation lights. That's just too cool. But are there any other new features in here that we could talk about? Obviously, the body is different.
All right. Sounds good, Jim. Well, let me bring the helicopter down and talk about it for a little bit. This new helicopter right here comes with one single cell 120 milliamp 14C battery now, which is an upgrade to the current mCX. It also includes higher powered motors in here, so you have a performance increase.
I thought it looked like it had a little more power.
It definitely does.
I like those rotor blades too. Look at that. They're of course carrying the blade logo on there, but painted rotor blades.
And yes.
And you guys are going all out on this thing. Well, what can we expect from this thing in terms of performance? You say it's a little better, and I'm sure we'll get a chance to fly it in here. But what was the idea there? More power?
Well, Jim, the idea here was to come up with something with a sleeker design. You know, we came up with a full body design, really nice and sleek, fast looking, which it is faster. It's a faster helicopter. It comes with an adjustable precision swash plate where you can actually switch, you know, turn the balls 90 degrees and use a longer set of control balls. And that'll give you, you know, a little bit quicker response and actually fly a little bit faster.
So you can start out with it in the basic setting.
Correct.
Kind of once you've got it all under control, which doesn't take too long, I don't think.
No, it doesn't take too long.
And then kind of move them to have a little bit of an upgrade in performance and left, right, fore and aft, and that sort of thing.
Very true, Jim.
I'm getting on.
On point, man. You know, we also added a few convenient features right here. You know, those of you that are familiar with the MCX currently uses little tiny O-rings to, you know, fasten the body on. Well, with this mCX2, perfect upgrade, by the way, or perfect helicopter for you beginner guys that want to get into this awesome RC helicopter flying stuff, you know? This one right here actually comes with single-piece grommets in the body, which are really small and stay on the body. So you can, you know, take the body off, perform your maintenance, and simply snap that right back on when you're done.
Okay, so you don't lose the little O-rings and have to chase them around and, you know, before the dog gets them or something, right?
Correct. You don't want the dog eating those O-rings.
Yeah, I know. I have enough trouble keeping them away from the helicopter.
Cool.
Well, this thing's looking very, very cool.
Definitely.
You know, let's talk about the parts a little bit.
Okay.
I know that a lot of people have got parts for their mCX, mm-hmm. and maybe they're even thinking of upgrading when they're seeing this. What do you got to say there? Are the parts kind of compatible, or what do you think?
Definitely, Jim. I mean, there's only just a few number of parts that are, you know, that are new specifically for the mCX2. I'd say 90% of the parts, the previous parts from the mCX, are compatible with this current helicopter. You know, some of the major changes are, of course, the 5-in-1 control unit. It's different, it has different software programming, the motors. You know, there's a few other little changes in the rotor head here that increase the performance of the helicopter, and of course, the appearance aspect. The body and the rotor blades are different. So other than that, the mainframe, I mean, pretty much, you know, some key aspects, you know, are changed, but most of it's pretty much the same. I mean,
well,
the landing gear is the same, so.
I don't care what you say. These flashing lights are just too cool.
Awesome.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
So that means you fly it at night too, right? After you turn the lights out.
It's really cool, Jim. I mean, you know, we've definitely experimented with that, flew it around and everything at night. You know, the reason why right is green and left is red is that's the aviation standard, you know. So at nighttime, the blue LED you can definitely see from the clear windshield right here.
Yeah, you see you've got a clear windshield too.
Oh yeah, I mean the current mCX, you know, nothing wrong with it, it's super this up a little bit more.
Do we call that an upgrade from the original, clear windshield? That's very cool.
Yeah, so this has that cool, you know, like high-end blue LED look, you know, flying around, and then you can identify where it's going from looking at the red tail, which slowly flashes, different flash rate than the side LEDs.
Yeah.
So
you
little
spend
details
a lot of time
right
on those lights, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, I love lights. Lights are really cool. It makes it more interactive, more fun.
I know, that's what it's all about. I see you've got another one here. What's up with this one?
Cool. All right, I thought you'd never ask, man. Well, you know what's cool about this product is that we know you guys want to customize everything. I know I do. So,
customization.
Yes, definitely. Cool thing about this helicopter, it looks good with the full body. And the lights?
Yeah.
But you can actually simplify it and kind of, you know, lean it out a bit and purchase, you know, one of our, it's called a carbon fiber tail boom assembly with fin. It's an option part.
It's got a little weight on it.
Oh, yeah. It's an adjustable, counterbalanced weight. Yes. Not only to compensate for the body, but you can actually fine-tune it for faster forward flight. So if you'd like, I'll go ahead and give it a shot right here.
Yeah, okay.
So, like I said, this is not included, you know. Pretty much all I'm using, the only thing different right now is I removed the rear section of the stock mCX2 and kept the front end of it, which is very easy to do. There's no screws to unbolt or anything. There, you know, once you take the front canopy off, you'll see a little connector that's attached to all the lights. And the cool thing about that is it's pre-wired already. So once you undo it, everything comes as a whole unit. So it's a whole, I mean, you don't have to undo anything else except for the two bodies. So.
Okay, but this one doesn't have a tail boom at all.
No, it doesn't.
This one uses the body as the tail boom.
Correct. So this one right here, I mean, it's really cool.
This is just an option part.
Oh, yeah.
Doesn't come in the package this way at all.
Oh, yeah. It's like, I mean, you can get it flying real quick here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
you
do like little funnels.
Oh, okay. I know you have fun with these things, Mark, because you're the product developer. But we got to get out there and fly these things a little bit, see what they look like in a natural setting.
Okay.
I do appreciate your coming in, Mark, and I know our viewers are going to enjoy this. The mCX is very popular. The mCX2 is going to be even more so. This is an absolutely great way to get started in radio control helicopters, and I think everybody will have a great experience.
Cool.
So I appreciate our viewers taking the time to see what Mark and I have had to say about the mCX2. Stick around for a little bit. We'll get a chance to fly it and show you what it looks like in the air.
Cool. Sounds good, Jim. Take care, guys.